Speaking of praying for people, just got a check in from Mark. We've been praying for Mark's wife, Beth. She had eye surgery yesterday, and he checked in this morning and said all went well, doing better today, and surgery went well. And so anyway, we continue to pray for Beth. Always encouraging you. Just want to take just a second. Mark reached out yesterday and shared that his wife, Beth, was going to be having eye surgery. We included her in our Divine Mercy chaplet, also included her, as Ron said, in our morning prayer yesterday with our team here. You're always welcome to do that. You're always welcome to send your prayer requests. We would love to pray for you. You can send those to chaplet prayer at gmail.com, chaplet prayer at gmail.com, or you can call our prayer request line anytime, day or night, 419-868-2966, 419-868-2966. Thanks, Mark, for letting us know that Beth is got through eye surgery well and is doing well today. Our word for today is free. Free is our word for today on this Wednesday of the fifth week of Lent, March 29th. Our reading from the book of the prophet Daniel, chapter 3. King Nebuchadnezzar said, "Is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you will not serve my God or worship the golden statue that I set up? Be ready now to fall down and worship the statue I had made. Whenever you hear the sound of the trumpet, flute, lyre, harp, psaltery, bagpipe, and all the other musical instruments, otherwise you shall be instantly cast into the white-hot furnace. And who is the God who can deliver you out of my hands?" Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered King Nebuchadnezzar, "There is no need for us to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If our God, whom we serve, can save us from the white-hot furnace and from your hands, O king, may he save us. But even if he will not, know, O king, that we will not serve your God or worship the golden statue that you set up." King Nebuchadnezzar's face became livid with utter rage against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He ordered the furnace to be heated 7 times more than usual and had some of the strongest men in his army bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and cast them into the white-hot furnace. Nebuchadnezzar rose in haste and asked his nobles, "Did we not cast 3 men bound into the fire?" "Assuredly, O king," they answered. But he replied, "I see 4 men, unfettered and unhurt, walking in the fire, and the 4th looks like a son of God." Nebuchadnezzar exclaimed, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel to deliver the servants who trusted in him. They disobeyed the royal command and yielded their bodies rather than serve or worship any god except their own God." Our responsorial psalm, also from the book of the prophet Daniel, chapter 3, and just as a heads up, this is the response of the men from the fire as they're saved in the fire. "Praise and glory forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious and exalted above all forever. Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious forever.
Blessed are they who have kept the word with a generous heart and yield a harvest through perseverance." A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him, "If you remain in my word, you will truly be my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. How can you say you will become free?" Jesus answered them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave of sin. A slave does not remain in a household forever, but a son always remains. So if the Son frees you, then you will truly be free. I know that you are descendants of Abraham, but you are trying to kill me because my word has no room among you. I tell you what I have seen in the Father's presence, then do what you have heard from the Father." They answered and said to him, "Our father is Abraham." Jesus said to them, "If you were Abraham's children, you would be doing the works of Abraham. But now you are trying to kill me, a man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. Abraham did not do this. You are doing the works of your father." So they said to him, "We are not born of fornication. We have one father, God." Jesus said to them, "If God were your father, you would love me, for I came from God and am here. I did not come on my own, but he sent me."
And our word for today, free our word for today, our Holy Father's thoughts regarding today's gospel reading. These he shared at his general audience on October the 6th, 2021. In fact, the truest freedom, that from slavery of sin, flows from the cross of Christ. We are freed from the slavery of sin by the cross of Christ. God placed the source of the liberation of the human person precisely there where Jesus allowed himself to be nailed, making himself a slave. This never ceases to amaze us, that the place where we are stripped of every freedom, that is, death, might become the source of freedom. But this is the mystery of God's love. It's not easily understood, but rather lived. Again, going back, this never ceases to amaze us, that the place where we are stripped of every freedom, that is death, might become the source of freedom. Boy, do we see that. Again, our word for today, free. Do we see that in the story today of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? And I want to point out something that I think is important as we go through this reading that is said. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered King Nebuchadnezzar, "There is no need for us to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If our God, whom we serve, can save us from the white hot furnace and from your hands, O king, may he save us." This is the line I want to point out. "But even if he will not, know, O king, that we will not serve your God or worship the golden statue that you set up." Sometimes, you know, and I think this is one of the things that we struggle with, right? In the midst of a fire, in the midst of difficulty in our lives, we absolutely know, there is no doubt in our minds, that God can reach through that thing and bring peace and conclusion to it immediately if he chooses to do so. I think we believe that. I think we believe that God is powerful enough to intercede on our behalf in any situation and bring it to an absolute conclusion, no matter how difficult it is, just by reaching into the fire, by accompanying us in the fire, allowing us, like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, to dance in the middle of the fire rather than to be burned up. Right? So we absolutely know that. We know that if he speaks a word, he can put an end to our trouble. There's no doubt about it. But here's the thing. That's not always the best course. What he makes clear to us is that's not always in our best interest. And Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego know this. They know that true freedom is not in knowing that God can save us in the midst of a difficult situation. True freedom is trusting God no matter what. And they say to King Nebuchadnezzar, you know, you say what God can save us from you. Well, we know what God can save us from you. But we'll serve him even if he doesn't, because we know that even if he allows us to be incinerated in your furnace, we'll be with him. We will be free. They walked into that furnace in absolute freedom without the promise that they would be saved in the midst of it. Now, did they feel even more free maybe as they danced around in the midst of that furnace, in the midst of that fire? Not by themselves, remember. There weren't three in the fire, there were four. And even King Nebuchadnezzar had to confess, "I see four in the fire, and one looks like the Son of God." Brothers and sisters, we are never in the fire alone. We never go through our difficulties alone. But I do think we need to train ourselves, like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, to say, "Lord, save me, but even if you don't, I love you. Save me from this situation, but Lord, even if you don't, I love you. I will serve you. I want to go nowhere else. I desire no one else. I desire only you. The world is not my answer." Sometimes difficulties visit us. And I pray sickness visits us, death visits us, violence visits us. and we go to the Lord and we ask for freedom from these things. We ask to be released from these things. But sometimes the answer is, this is not my will for you. My will for you is that you endure this. And through the endurance of this thing, that you become strong in me. Does that mean the Lord created it for us? No, absolutely not. That's not the truth. But he allows us to go through difficult times that are visited upon us because we live in a broken world. We have a broken nature of our own, and we live with people who have broken nature and sometimes welcome evil into their own lives and participate with evil. And we become the victim of some of these individuals and some of these individual circumstances. But in the midst of it, we find strength. Yet beyond that, not just strength, we find freedom. And in the midst of this endurance that we show in the midst of difficult circumstances, the King Nebuchadnezzar's around us rise and say, oh my goodness, it's not just him alone. It's not just her alone. There's someone accompanying them. There's no way they could be dancing in the midst of the fire if they aren't being accompanied, if someone wasn't helping them. And so Nebuchadnezzar says, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel to deliver the servants who trusted in him. They disobeyed the royal command and yielded their bodies rather than serve or worship any god except their own God. What a testimony that is. So we are free, Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him. And I know I'm going a little long here today, but I'm telling you, this line gets me. It doesn't say Jesus said to the scribes, to the Pharisees. He didn't say to the pagan. He said to those who believed in him. Jesus said to the Jews who believed in him, if you remain in my word, you will be truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. And what is the response of those who believed in him? They answered, we're descendants of Abraham. We've never been enslaved to anyone. How can you say you will become free? He says, oh, your pride. Oh, your pride. You're a slave. You're a slave to sin. You're a slave to death. You're a slave to the evil one. I have come that you might be free. And only when we recognize we need that freedom from him can we truly go to him and give ourselves completely to him and then be truly free. Free, our word for today.